This is Srinivas Lakhim. Today we are going to see how to change file or directory permissions. Do you know how to change? To change file or directory permissions, we use command call chmod. Chmod. Before that, let's see what are the file permissions for file or directory. Okay? I'm opening terminal. So currently I'm in root home directory. I'm creating one file saying demo. In this file I'm writing some content. You can write any content. This is used to test file permissions. File permissions. Save this file. How do we save this one? Control D. Okay, Control D. Let's see what are file permissions of this file. What are file permissions? ls space hyphen l file name demo. ls space hyphen l file name demo. See, these are file permissions. So when you create any file, so this is first one is file type. Last class we seen what is this complete structure. So this is file type. This is file permissions for owner. This is file permissions for group and file permissions for other. So when you create a file or directory, it will assign permissions for owner, or we call user, group and others. Okay, it will assign permissions for owner, group, others. So permissions are read, write, execute, read, write, execute permissions. So we can represent these permissions in symbolic way. Read we represent in R, write we represent in W, execute we represent in X. In Linux system, they represent read in R, write in W, execute in X. So you see here those permissions. Okay. Next, in numeric representation, R represents in 4, W represents 2, execute represents in 1. Okay, read represents in symbolic way R, in numeric way we represents 4, write represents in W, in numeric way we represents 2, execute represents as X, numeric way it represents 1. Okay, so when you create file, the default permissions are See, this is for owner or user. This is for group. This is for others. Okay? Let's copy this one. These are default permissions. So, read means four, right? Sorry. This is for owner. This is for user. This is for group. This is for other. Okay? Owner 4 plus 2 hyphen means 0. Okay? Read means 2. Sorry, read means 4 plus hyphen means 0 plus hyphen means 0. Here, read means 4, hyphen means 0, hyphen means 0. So, default file permissions for user is 6, user or owner is 6, group is 4, and others is 4. So, these are default permissions on file. Let's create directory. So I am creating directory. Directory name, let's see. Yeah, I have already created Synotec. I want to see what are default file permissions of directory Srinivas. Let's remove, maybe we assigned different permissions. I am removing this Synotec directory first. And let's create now. Okay, create directory. How do we create directory? Mkdir, and directory name is Synotec. Okay, next let's see the default directory permissions. So these are default directory permissions. Okay, default file permissions, same as I am writing default directory permissions. Default directory permissions are these. Okay, this is directory. So this is for owner or user. This is for group and others. So this is for user. This is for group. This is for others. Okay? So see what are default permissions for owner and group. 4 plus 2 plus 1. 4 plus 0 plus 1. That is 7, 7, 5, 5. So default permissions on directory is 7, 5, 5. Default permissions on file is 6, 4, 4. Okay. So what are full permissions? Full permissions on full permissions and default permissions. So full permissions on file. File and full permissions on directory. So full permissions on file is six, six, six. Full permissions on directory is 7, 7, 7. What are default permissions on file? 6, 4, 4, right? What are default permissions on directory? 7, 5, 5, right? Then so if you minus default permissions from full permissions, we'll get 0, 2, 2, 0, 2, 2. These values are called UMASK values. These values are called UMASK values. UMASK values. So if anyone asks what are UMASK values on file and directory, these are UMASK values 0, 2, 2, 0, 2. How do we get UMASK values on files and directories? So you find, right, if you create any file, the default permissions are these. If you create any directory, default permissions on directory is this. If you deduct default permissions from full permissions, we will get UMASK value. Okay? Okay, these are default UMASK values. These are default file permissions. I want to change file permissions. If you want to change file permissions, file or directory, file or directory permissions, we use chmod command. If you want to change file or directory permissions, we use chmod command. So to change file permissions or directory permissions, we can apply in two ways. One is symbolic way. And another one is numeric way. We can change file permissions or directory permissions in two ways. One is symbolic way and another one is numeric way. To change file permissions, we use chmod command only. By using symbolic way or by using numeric way, we apply or we change permissions. First, let's see symbolic way. How do we change permissions in symbolic way? Change file or directory permissions. In symbolic way. Symbolic way. file are directory permissions in symbolic way. Okay. First, my requirement is remove read permissions to others. First requirement, remove read permissions to others on file demo. So just now we created file demo, right? Here we created file demo, so these are file permissions of demo. So if you use this command, we got this file permissions, right? So others has read permission. My requirement is read permissions to others on file demo. So to remove that file permissions, we use command call chmod. So how do we apply this one in symbolic way? We are seeing here. See, ls -l demo. So this is read permissions. I want to remove read permissions to others. We have some special operations in symbolic way. To add permissions, we use symbol plus. To remove permissions, we use symbol minus. To remove permissions, we use symbol minus. To all user or group or user and group and others, we use symbol A. A stands for all. Okay. To assign, we use symbol equal to. Character A. Okay. Let's remove permissions to other users on file demo. Let's see practically how do we removing chmod. I want to remove permissions for which one? Others, right? Others are represented owner or user represents symbol U. Group represents with symbol G. Others represents symbol here. I want to remove right R, R minus, sorry, O minus read permission, O minus read on which file? Demo file. Let's see ls-l demo. Did you observe? This is for group, this is for, sorry, this is for owner, this is for group, and this is for others, right? In others, read permission is removed, right? Okay, next requirement is remove read permission to group. Remove read permission to group. Can you tell me how do we remove read permission to group? How do we remove read permission to group? Chmod group represents G. To remove we use -n. We want to remove what is the permission? Read. Okay, on which file? Demo file. That's it. ls-l demo. See, this is for group, right? Read permission is removed. Others also read permission already removed. Okay. Next requirement. Give read write permissions to group and others. Group and others. Give read write permissions to group and others. Can you tell me the command? Chmod group plus read write comma read write comma other plus read write on which file? Demo file. Or we can write one more way. Chmod sorry, group others plus read write on which file? Demo file. In these two way we can give read write permissions on demo file. Let's see practically. Chmod group others plus read write on demo file. ls-l demo. Sorry. So read write. Okay. Next, one more requirement is give full permissions on file demo for all means full permissions means read 644, right? Full permissions, sorry, 666, right? Full permissions. How do we give full permissions for all? We use command chmod user group others plus read write on demo or chmod a plus read write on demo. We already discussed a stands for user group others, right? All. Okay, let's execute this command. So I am creating one file, new file, cat greater than test file, some text, control D, ls-l test. So these are default permissions. I am changing chmod. I am giving full permissions to all users. A plus read write, full permissions, right? Read write test. ls-l test. So read write full permissions. We give full permissions to all users on file test. Okay, so this is symbolic way. Next, numeric way. Next one, how do we give permissions by in numeric way? So numeric way, we also discussed R is for write means to, execute means 1, right? So we use same command, chmod command, but values are numeric way. Okay, see, I am creating one file, new file, cat greater than AA, and I am writing to test file permissions in numeric way. Okay, control D, ls-l AA. So these are default file permissions. These are default file permissions. I want to give full permissions. Give full permissions. Full permissions on file AAA. Okay, let's see how do we give full permissions. Chmod. What are full permissions? 6, 6, 6, on which file? AAA. ls-l space AA. See, read, write, execute, read, write, read, write, read, write. Okay? So, in this way we give, numeric way we give in this format. Okay, so symbolic way we seen, numeric way we seen. Most of the times people will use numeric way instead of symbolic way because it is easy, but you have to know this is for user, this is for group, this is for others. But symbolic way, clearly we know U stands for user, G stands for group, O stands for others. So symbolic way, we clearly give for root user, we want to give, for user, we want to give what are the permissions, for group, what are the permissions, for others, what are the permissions. But here, we have to know what is this one, what is this one, what is this one. Okay? That's it. Okay? Thank you.